This forward running man with the, hey, give me the, with the pasta. What a weird move. This dance is weird, but it's so good. And that pisses me off. Hey y'all, it's Clay from Steezy. It's been a long time, but we're back and doing dancer breakdowns. And today we're gonna be watching Magnetic by Eyelet. We're watching the dance practice, of course, because we're here to break down dances.
Baby, I'm just trying to play cool, but I just can't hide that.
Cute.
I want you. Wait a minute. In your mouth, it's an action. Tell me
you love that. It's so clean and so like snappy. Did you see the way that the center dancer in yellow hits this like shockwave of a body wave on that landing? They do this boom. It's just such a weirdly grimy move for something that's kind of adorable. So clean. Yes, arm snap. Okay. Hit a little bedrock with the feet right there. You got a little e. It's kind of cool because there's not many moves that you can stay back on your heels and make look cool. Everything is really like forward and dance very often because they're trying to be agile. But this move, you can. So as Bianca says in her class on Steezy,
you want to think about pivoting first onto those heels. Then you want to think about lifting the leg while you pivot. Just start there. And then the next one, you want to think about toe, ball, heel.
Ooh, they hit that little. What a weird move. This dance is weird in like the best way possible, where it makes it look super unique. And I don't know, there's something about these really defined hand positions that's just doing it for me. The beautiful ripple, yes.
This time I want
hip sway. I'm gonna talk about this thing later involving knees, but the big thing is that when you're doing these sort of hip sway movements, it's really, really important to bend your knees. Bianca talks about this in one of her other hip movement classes.
What I want you to do for now is find that plie in your knees, something nice and comfortable, where you're in a little bit of a bouncy bend, so it's easy to transfer weight over from side to side.
Yeah, good little ripple catch on. Hit, hand. Ooh. I feel like that's the part that everyone wants to learn, honestly. Like, it's gotta be, right? That's the part that's so, so unique to this dance. Who are the choreographers for this? Let me see. Okay, so judging by Luna Hyun, who's the performance director, you have choreographers Todd Williamson, Rena Hattori, Renan, the Rodriguez family, and then somebody named James. People are presuming that it's the ex-trainee A, James, but I don't know. Those are the people though. And whatever they're doing something right. The way that the hips are complementing this little look, I can't even do it right. It's super, super cool. Like I said before, snappiness. This dance has so much snap to the entire thing. And I think that's the one thing I'm noticing from this dance as a whole, is that it's deceivingly a hands dance, right? The catchy horseshoe magnet hands and the super intricate chorus, but what really sells these upper body movements is the obnoxiously grounded lower body. You'll notice like throughout the entire thing, their knees are not only like bent for the majority of the dance to give them like a lot of stability and like room for agile movements, but their legs and hips also have just as much texture as the upper body. Like try like putting your hand and covering the upper body and seeing what I'm talking about when you look at their legs. Look at this. Tap, tap, hip, yes. You guys looking at those legs? You gotta try the thing here, okay? You gotta see that, like, especially that last little bit. Their legs are snappy. They're on it. Hey, hey, hey. Hit a little Charleston, okay. You know, the Charleston is one of those dances that is deceivingly like a foot dance, like you think you're just focusing on this, but in reality, it's very much an upper body dance as well. You want to stay pretty darn lifted. Our jazz instructor, Laura, actually talks about it in her class.
So let's transport back in time. Think 1920s, think flapper girls. So imagine that fringe dress moving around. So before we were kind of bouncing heavy down low, I want us to bring our bounce up a little higher.
So she mentions like the flapper dances, but in reality, it's actually an older African dance that, of course, jazz is still African dance, but in the newer era. That little chest snappiness. Okay, hit that little Jersey Club hit. Nice. Ooh, little bounce, bounce, bounce. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. What is this again? It's like the beginning of hitting like a city rock almost, you know? Just hitting these little shoulder bounces. Super cute. A little cute lift. Man, I swear, this right here, if there's any move in dance that I would never have done in my entire life or chosen for that moment, it's this street sign pedestrian crossing position. But it's so good, and that pisses me off. That weird move is not supposed to be so effective, but it has to do with their hip sways and the placement of it being so gentle amongst all this snappy movement. Man, I mean, I'm in love with this dance. It's so weird, and I love that. That hip part after. Oh, see, there's this little transition thing that's happening here, which I think a lot of groups would really lean into these moments as like making it a full moment, but they have these little parts in between that are so slick that keep the dance rolling. It helps build momentum. You'll notice like right after they do this chorus, super, and you see she goes whoom, and continues on rather than making like a boom, ka. It is such a nice little whoom, toss, continue on. Lots of flair there. It's great. Okay. Yeah. It's a little air walk. Okay. Ooh, so much play. Hey. Oh. What? Ugh! I hate it, but I like it. I'm so mad. Guys, this forward running man with the, give me the, with a pasta kind of hands thing, it's horrendous. But I'm sweating because I really like it. It just works. Like, what is this moment? What is this little? Like, why did she hit the Humpty dance? Yeah, do the Humpty hump, do the Humpty. She hit the Humpty dance, but like in a fast little doll-like motion. Okay, I'm gonna work it up. I'm gonna chill. Okay. And that running man, who does that? And then she's drying her hands after. This is bad good. This is unfortunately fantastic. Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. Solid pose, yeah. Ah! Yo, when they hit this magnetic, like, just pull it up to center. Doesn't that kind of look like Magnemite, like the Pokemon? Do you think they, do you think they thought about Magnemite? Hey, what sound does Magnemite make in Pokemon? Comment down below. Hey. I don't club hips again. Ooh, solid ending pose too. They have that nice little continue on. It's a very good closing position. Okay, so I hate this dance because it makes me love these really weird movements. And that really makes me upset. I would have never thought to do these things ever in my entire life. But it's so effective because of the grounded base that they use with their legs. It makes the upper body look snappy. These hand positions are so well specifically choreographed that it becomes like iconic imagery. Like I can't help but anytime I see this, I'm not even gonna think about like Spider-Man anymore. That's obnoxious. If you guys wanna see another video with like really, really great choreographed hands, you gotta check out the Irene and Solgi Naughty video. But we did a reaction with the choreographer Spella, and she's super sick because she combines both whacking and tutting into her choreography. And those are very, very good upper body dances with very specific hands. So check that out. So in closing, this video was fire. I loved it. If you enjoyed this, comments what video you want to watch in the future. Subscribe to our channel and give this video a like to help us in the algorithm, and I'll see you next time.
Cut!